what's it gonna be? What's up, everyone? Lenny Get a Life is Now. Today, in this box, I have 10 Vitamix accessories, 10 things that can help make Vitamix owning better, easier, less wasteful. Here we go, I wanna show you. First thing, chef's knife. You need a really good chef's knife. It's not worth your time to be messing around with a throwaway chef's knife. It makes the whole experience of preparing your green juice, of chopping vegetables into golf ball sized pieces, of getting your accoutrements ready for dipping with a proper chef's knife. This is the Mac knife, the mighty Mac knife. It was recommended to us by the Wirecutter as the best knife for most people. You only need one knife. This is the one, and to go along with it, knife sharpener. Get these. Next up, something to hold your lemons. You might not use the whole lemon in your green juice or in your salad dressings that you're making. Don't use a plastic bag. Get a little lemon holder like this, because if you put it in a Tupperware or whatever container that you cannot see through, you're not gonna know it's there. You're gonna end up throwing it away. These usually come in a set of an avocado holder and an onion holder. We use all three, love them. Next up, mason jars. In these 8-ounce mason jars, we like to put pesto, nut butters, our queso, if we're making baby food, onions, pickled onions, if we're making jackfruit tacos and we wanna get real fancy with it. Pretty much everything goes in these. Leftovers, they're see-through, they're great. And the tops on these are compatible with the 32-ounce mason jars. We use these almost exclusively for green juice. We make green juice every other day, 64 ounces, and we store half of it. And I bring these down to my office and drink out of these mason jars too. So, 32-ounce mason jars, 8-ounce mason jars, lids that are compatible with both. And speaking of green juice, if you have children, get them started early. This one from OXO, this baby cup, fill it with green juice, we love it. Next thing you need. Neither Shalvin or I grew up with an ice cube maker in our fridge. We made our own ice in ice cube trays. We are very grateful to have an ice cube maker in our fridge now, but we have two other kinds of ice cube trays. One, these little teeny tiny ones. They are great for leftover coffee, to make tiny little coffee cubes. You can pop them out by pressing the button, pop, 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 or a coconut milk. Put it in here for making ice cream. Another one that's actually helpful for baby food. You make a batch, fill up these cubes, pop them out, and then giant ice cube trays. And this is for soup. So these are, what are these called? Super trays, super whatever. I guess we'll put the link in the description. These are for soup. They are 250 milliliters each, and they are great for making a giant batch of soup, putting it in here. And since they're made of silicone, they're easy to get out. You kind of just push, wiggle, wiggle. These are not cheap, but there's nothing like them, and we've found them to be really useful and worth the money. So you made soup, and what are you gonna put with it? A nice salad, a homemade salad dressing. If you're bringing it to a party, you probably don't wanna put it in the 20-ounce container with the to-go cup. So get one of these little guys. Salad dressing container, you can bring it to the party, and when you're done with it, you can bring it home, throw it in the fridge. I hate to ask, could you hit the thumbs up button? It really helps us get found, and it's just really helpful. Thanks, really appreciate it. Ding. All right, next up, dessert. Make ice cream in your Vitamix, it's the best. And ice cream, every time we make it, we're thrilled that we do. Get a scooper, one of these scoopers like they have in elementary school to scoop the mashed potatoes, another OXO brand. Something also about the stainless steel hitting, if you have one, the stainless steel container. Quite satisfying. What's it gonna be? Next up, a brownie tin. Yes, if you're making brownies, we have a black bean brownie that's really good. Put them in here, ready-made brownies. You don't have to cut them. Every piece has an edge, which are the crunchy, crispy parts that are the best. But also for ice cream. When you're making a huge batch of ice cream in your Vitamix, it's nice to have it right then, but then also to pre-portion scoops for later. So you take that ice cream scooper, wherever it went, right here, into the container, and then scoop yourself, go One, two, three, four, five, six, and pop them in the freezer. When you're ready to have one of those scoops, take it out, pop off that one scoop that you want, and then let it sit on the counter for 5 minutes, and you have a ready-made, perfect little serving of ice cream. Next up, pancakes. Pancake squeeze bottle. I love to make pancakes on the weekends. And if you want to get really special with it, make some pancake creatures or animals or characters, I guess is the word for it. My favorite one that I've ever made is Maui from Moana. I was really proud of that one. Put a little piece of spinach, a couple of raisins, some almonds for his whatever. He had a hook made out of coconut. It was cool. You'd be super dad with one of these. They're like, no, really cheap, $5. Guys, the last one, it's not in here. It's empty, is a scrub brush. It's got the brush and a thing you can put soap in the handle and give it a little squeeze to get soap out of it. So the containers these days are dishwasher safe, but you don't always want to put it in the dishwasher, but sometimes you need to, and the wash cycle doesn't always do a perfect job without a tiny bit of pre-cleaning. Anyways, this is the best brush that you can get, or best tool that you can get to keep your Vitamix clean. Scrub brush from OXO. Link in bio. Guys, subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Hit that bell to get notified. And if you appreciate videos like this, accessories and tips and tricks about Vitamix, things for Vitamix owners, hit that thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.